大家晚上好，我是张一鸣。
On behalf of Home of Christ Fremont, we would like to extend a warm welcome to everyone here tonight.
我们代表 Fremont 基督之家，欢迎在座每一位。
We are glad that you are here tonight to celebrate with us the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ.
很高兴能与大家一起庆祝我们主耶稣基督的诞生。
First, we ask Elder Shaw to lead us in tonight's opening prayer.
首先我们请肖长老带我们做一个开始祷告。
好，让我们一同低头祷告。天上的父神，主耶稣基督，我们今天真的是满心欢喜快乐来到你的家中，因为我们大人小孩，我们弟兄姐妹与朋友们，我们都要一同来庆祝我们主耶稣的降生。主耶稣基督在2000多年前借着圣灵感孕，生在马槽里，我们一同的在这边来庆祝这样的一个大的日子，因为这是一个划时代的日子，整个历史的重要的日子。那一天，天使来跟牧羊人报这个佳音，说在至高之上荣耀归于神，在地上平安归于他所喜悦的人。我们都是神所喜悦的人，愿平安在我们每一位心中。When Jesus was born about 2000 years ago, angels told the shepherds about the event and told them that good news and the glory in the highest, the glory to God on earth, the peace to those on whom his favor rests. 我们要一同感恩，我们要一同庆祝主耶稣基督与我们生活在一起，充充满满的有真理，有恩典。我们今天都蒙了他的拣选，成为基督徒，也让我们照着2000多年前的天使一样，我们要把主耶稣降生大好的信息，这样的一个佳音，跟我们的亲戚、我们的朋友、我们的同学、我们的邻居一同来传讲这样的美好的信息。求主今天带领我们晚上的时间，让我们大人小孩都一同喜乐，把主耶稣降生这样美好的信息放在我们每一个人的心里。我们一生一世都要做主忠实的门徒，为主摆上。感谢祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名，阿门。
Thank you, Elder Shaw.Now, without further ado, we present to you our Christmas program. Shout the good news!
音乐节目现在开始，欢呼，传好福音。我们有请中文学校上来表演。
throughout the Bible, such as Moses, Abraham, Isaiah, and Micah. They are just some of the many Old Testament prophets. These messengers serve as voices of God, speaking promises as well as warnings to God's chosen people.
The Old Testament prophets provided hope for the Israelites who were living in bondage and darkness. The Israelites were waiting for the Messiah to come and set them free.
The prophet Isaiah gave reassuring words to the Israelites about the coming of the Promised One.
Be strong, do not fear. Your God will come, and He will come to save you. Go up on a high mountain and lift your voice with a shout. Lift it up and do not be afraid. Here is your God, for to us a child is born, to us a son is given.
Another prophet, Micah, told the Israelites where the Promised One would come.
You, Bethlehem, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come one who will be ruler over Israel.
Into the Old Testament. The good news continues into the New Testament too.
Zechariah and Elizabeth were in their old age when God gave them their first child, a son that they were to name him John. An angel told them that this son would bring them joy and that he would be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from birth.
The son, who would eventually be known as John the Baptist, became the messenger that was foretold by the prophet Isaiah hundreds of years ago. Voice of one calling.
In the desert, prepare the way for the Lord. Make straight in the wilderness a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Overwhelmed and perplexed by the news. How can this be? I am a virgin.
The angel Gabriel answered, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. This Holy One will be called the Son of God.
I am the Lord's servant. May it be to me as you have said.
An angel of the Lord also appeared to Joseph, saying,
Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, because what is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are named Jesus. He will save his people from their sins.
Late in Mary's pregnancy, she and Joseph left Nazareth in response to the Roman decree that a census be taken. Because Joseph belonged to the house and line of David, they went to Bethlehem.
While in Bethlehem, the time came for the baby to be born. Mary gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because they were unable to find a room in town.
Keeping watch over their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, the night sky shone as bright as day, and they were terrified. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, saying,
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy. Today, in the town of David, a Savior is born. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those who are pleased.
Sing we all of the same. after the angels had departed, the shepherds said to one another,
where they found Mary, Joseph, and the newborn baby Jesus who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word about what they had witnessed.
All who heard their story were amazed. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen.
to tell the good news.
Wow, good news. Christina, what good news?
That Jesus Christ is born.
Woo, amen, hallelujah.
Mary and Joseph took their newborn son to the temple in Jerusalem to dedicate him to God in accordance with Jewish custom.
While they were there, Simeon, a righteous and faithful servant of God, whom the Holy Spirit also arrived at the temple. Simeon had been promised by God that he would not die before he had seen the Christ.
There was also an elderly prophetess, Anna, who lived at the temple worshiping God day and night. At this moment, she too came up to Mary and Joseph while giving thanks to God and Messiah.
Simeon and Anna came with him that day to fulfill the promises of God as they celebrated the birth of Jesus.
Thank you.
prophets.
We are like Mary and Joseph, the angels and the shepherds.
We are all witnesses to the birth of the Christ child.
Like the prophets of old, Zechariah and Elizabeth, John the Baptist, and so many others who have gone before us, we are challenged to be God's messengers, to bear the good news.
What is good news?
The Messiah has come.
Come, let us adore him, and let us celebrate his birth.
Glory to the world.
Christmas. Every time that we celebrate Christmas, that you always can hear something like that. A joyful voice. And our people always say this is a season to be jolly. Merry Christmas. Whenever that we see that you can see the Christmas trees and the gifts, decoration of lights, and baby Jesus. But I want to ask you a question. What is the Christmas spirit? A lot of people said, when you say ho, 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 that's is the Christmas spirit. When you laugh, when you greet each other, when you give each other blessing, the gifts, and all that, it's Christmas spirit. Dressing red and green, those are part of Christmas spirit as well. Indeed, they're all part of it. But what is a true Christmas spirit?
Since we're talking about spirit, then we must understand the spirit is from within. Is the connection between human and God. And is a true understanding of what Christmas is all about. Our heart needs to be touched, and our heart needs to be inspired. And all inside our heart, we need to truly understand and have a true feeling of happiness. It's sort of like the light inside of us that is warm and that is bright. The true Christmas spirit is to understand that Jesus Christ has been born. And that is true, and that is not a make-up story. Not only his birth has changed our life, he also changed the human life. That's why the calendar says 2015. And next year, coming up, 2016. Now, in the Bible, the book of Luke, chapter 2, in that it says, but the angel said to them, the shepherds, do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. In the beginning, people do not quite understand why a baby was born, although they've been told that is born for all of us. It's the Savior. It is the Messiah. It's the Lord. And he said, you go find it. The baby is wrapped in cloth and laid down in the manger, and that is a sign. But people didn't understand that because the baby become a man, Son of God. And after 33 years that he was on earth, and he died on the cross for all of us. And then we realized that he died for our sins. And book of John chapter 3 verse 16, it says, for God so loved the world that he gave us his only son, that whoever believed in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Verse 17, it says, for God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Jesus came for us. And he died on the cross for us. Now we celebrate that because now our sins were forgiven. Now we've been given an opportunity of renewal for our lives. So what is the Christmas spirit? Because God so loved the world, so he gave us his only son. So he gave something to us. That something is a great salvation through his son Jesus. So there is a reason, there is an action, and there is a purpose. The purpose of Jesus
was born is to save the world, save you and I. That's the purpose. So love is the cause of it. And the purpose of that is for us to be saved. Now, what do we need to respond to that understanding? The understanding is God has loved us, so therefore we understand that, then we need to respond to that love. But what is love? The love is to give forgiveness, to be compassionate, to give help and hope, encouragement, guidance, and patience to one another. If we can do that, we are response to God's love. God so loved the world, He gave us His only Son. And what do we need to give to others? And that's why people bring joy to each other. People greet each other. People bless each other. People pass gifts to each other. Because the purpose of that, all that is to say, I love you. So that is Christmas spirit. Right, thank you.
Thank you, Elder
Song. 谢谢宋长老.
Now that we have heard the wonderful Christmas message, I do what? Exactly.
是的，我知道 耶稣爱我。 你们呢?
Then we ask that you extend Merry Christmas greetings to at least 5 people around you.
那就让我们与身边5个朋友握手，说声圣诞快乐。
We hope everyone heard the good news tonight. And what is the good news?
The Messiah has come. Hallelujah.
Our program ends here tonight. We ask Minister Jerome to lead us in closing prayer. Afterwards, please join us for refreshments outside.
今晚的节目即将结束。 我们请徐凡道带我们做一个结束祷告，祷告完以后，请大家到后面享用点心。
Good evening, everyone. We're almost done. At this time, I'd like you to close your eyes, bow your head, and give praise to our Lord Jesus Christ for His birthday. The passage that we're going to meditate on comes from Luke chapter 2, verse 25 to 32. Luke chapter 2, verse 25 to 32. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon, and this man was righteous and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. And it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. And he came in the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus, to do for him according to the custom of the law, he took him up in his arms and blessed God and said, Lord, now you are letting your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation that you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this night that we could come and sing before you, that we could celebrate before you, that we can remember you, Lord Father God. We love seeing the children. We love being able to use our talents and gifts to serve you and to show other people, Lord Father God, what you have given to us. But most important, Lord Father, we want to remain thankful for our Lord Jesus Christ. Without him, as we keep saying, we would have no life. So we give you praise, we give you honor, we give you glory. We ask, Heavenly Father, that you'd go with us tonight, Lord Father. May you continue to grow us and mold us and shape our hearts, Lord Father God, to be more Christ-like. We thank you so much for sending our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us so that we could live, and we celebrate his birth together. Thank you, Jesus, for coming to us, for willingly coming and taking your sin, our sins upon your shoulders, Father. We thank you and praise all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Good night, Merry Christmas.